The second type of terminators are RHO independent terminators. They are also called intrinsic terminators because they don't need any other factors for termination. They consist of two sequence elements, a short inverted repeat of 20 nucleotides followed by a stretch of about 80 base pairs. So this specific sequence, there is about 20 inverted repeat. 20 nucleotides are present and they are inverted in the following sequence. So if ATGC here in this will be reverted. So ATGC will become TAGCG. So it will revert. So there is a 20 nucleotide long sequence of inverted nucleotides, and then this sequence is followed by 880 adenine thymine base pairs. So here you can see in this figure, here this is RNA polymerase, and this is this yellow one is first sequence, and then this green one is the inverted sequence of this yellow sequence. So this is about 20 nucleotide long sequence, and then it is followed by 80 80 80, is a small stretch of 80 sequence. These elements do not affect the polymerase until they have been transcribed. That is, they function in RNA rather than in the DNA. So although these elements or these sites are present in DNA, but they do not work in DNA until this specific portion is transcribed. So when this specific sequence is transcribed into mRNA, then it will work. When polymerase transcribes an inverted repeat sequence, the resulting RNA can form a stem loop structure, often called a hairpin, by base pairing with itself. So when this inverted sequence it passes the transcription and it transcribed into mRNA, after transcription it makes a stem loop by base pairing with itself, because these two sequences are complementary inverted sequences. Formation of the hairpin loop causes termination by disrupting the elongating complex. So here you can see this is RNA transcript, and this one is that loop. And here you can see this is the sequence. It is rich in GC content, and this whole, this is a stem loop, and this is followed by UUU. So when this loop is formed, this loop followed by a small stretch of U, and it causes the polymerase to dissociate from the complex. So in this way it stops transcription. The hairpin induces termination by either pushing polymerase forward relative to the DNA and RNA, wresting the transcript from polymerase, or inducing a conformational change in polymerase. So all these three explanations are just similar to the RHO dependent terminators. The hairpin works as an efficient terminator only when it is followed by a stretch of AU base pairs. So in the DNA, this sequence was ATAT, but here between RNA and DNA, this sequence is AUAUAU. This is because under those circumstances, at the time of hairpin forms, the growing RNA chain will be held on the template at the active site by only AU base pairs. So when a loop will be formed, so this RNA transcript will be attached to the DNA template only through this AU attachments, base pairs. Because AU base pairs are the weakest of all base pairs, because you know between GC there are 3 hydrogen bonds and between AT there are 2 hydrogen bonds. So AT is weaker than GC base pairing. So this AU is even weaker than AT base pairs. They are more easily disrupted by the effects of stem loop on the transcribing polymerase, and thus the RNA will more readily dissociate. So it can easily dissociate because the interaction between this transcript and DNA is very weak. This is mRNA transcript, and this is the stem loop or hairpin loop, and this loop is followed by a small stretch of this AU sequence. This is the weakest interaction between mRNA and DNA template. So it can easily dissociate from the DNA.